Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create some simple 2D animations in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. All right, my fellow bros. In this video, we're going to be animating an image on a canvas. We're only going to be moving this image up, down, left, and right. Feel free to download an image that you want to use. I'm just going to use this UFO emoji that I found. So we'll need two imports at the top from tkinter, import everything. That's what we usually have. We'll also need to import time as well. We'll need a window, window equals tk followed by window.main loop. We'll need a canvas. I'm going to call the canvas canvas. Canvas equals canvas. We're adding the canvas to the window. I'm going to create something that's called a constant. We're going to create a constant for the width and the height of our canvas. So a constant is a variable or value that you don't plan on changing later at all. And a common naming convention for a constant is that the name of the constant is all uppercase. So I want the width and the height of this canvas to be constants. So for the width, this is going to be all uppercase. It's not necessary to make it all uppercase, but that's a common naming convention. For the width, I'm going to set this to 500, and the height set to 500 as well. And for the width of this canvas, I'm going to set the width to equal my constant, which is 500, and the height to my constant height. So the reason that I'm making constants is that we'll be reusing these a lot later in this program, so we might as well just declare them now and get it over with. So for the canvas, we're adding this to the window, we're setting the width to our constant of width, and the height to our constant of height. And we need to follow this by packing this, or place, canvas.pack. Pack to make it simple. So we should have a canvas on our window. Now if you have an image that you want to use, we're going to animate it. I need to create a photo image from this file. It's a PNG file, it's called UFO, but yours is probably going to be named something different, so don't copy me exactly. I need to create a photo image from this. I'm going to call this photo underscore image, but name it whatever you want. This equals photo image, and I need to list the file path or the file name. Since this file is within my project folder, I only have to list the file name, and for me, this is called ufo.png. Our next step is that we're going to take our photo image and add this photo image to the canvas. And we'll also give this image a unique name. I'm going to call this my image equals, we're going to use the canvas's create image function. So canvas.createImage. There's a few arguments that we need to pass in. Where we want this image to appear, we need a set of coordinates. If we want this to appear in the top left corner, that is where x is 0 and y is 0. For the image, we're going to set this equal to our photo image, whatever you named this. And lastly, we should anchor this. I'm going to anchor this in the northwest corner to keep it simple. And we should have our image on our canvas in the top left corner. And here is my UFO that's being piloted by a green alien that's waving to me. Aliens are usually not that friendly unless they're abducting you. Our next step is to create a while loop. So we'll say while true. This will continue forever until we close out of the program. If you're looking at the code for a game, this might say instead while running. Running will be a Boolean variable that contains either true or false. So if this is true while the game is running, they're going to continue moving all of the characters on the screen. And then if somebody pauses the game or closes out of the game, then they'll flip this running variable to false. But to keep things simple, we'll just say while true, but that's something that you might see. What we'll want to do is get the coordinates of our image within the canvas, and this will return a list of coordinates. So let's create a list called coordinates. So coordinates equals canvas, and we can use the coords function to get the coordinates. I guess that's short for coordinates. And we're getting the coordinates of my image, so we'll pass this into this function. And then let's print this, just to see what this returns. We'll print coordinates. Okay, now to update the window after each cycle of this while loop, we can use the update function of our window. So window.update, We'll also have this thread sleep for, let's say, 0.01 seconds. So time.sleep 0.01. So here's a quick rundown of what we have going on so far within this while loop. We're going to first get the coordinates of where our image is located. We'll print the coordinates to the console window. This part isn't required, but it's going to help us for our learning purposes. We'll update this window for any changes, and then our thread, which is in charge of running the program, is going to sleep for, I believe that's a hundredth of a second. So when we run this, our image is staying in place, and we know that our while loop is running because it's continuously printing the coordinates. The first number is the X position, the second number is the Y position. Now we're going to give our image a speed, or velocity. I like to call it velocity. And in fact, I'm going to give this image two velocities, one for how fast this image is moving on the x-axis, and another for how fast it's moving on the y-axis. So I'm going to create two variables, one called x-velocity, and I'm going to set this equal to 1, and y-velocity, and I'll set this to 1 as well. Okay, so what we need to do now is update the position of our image. So let's do that before we update our window. So I'm going to type in the name of the canvas and use the move function. This move function takes three arguments. What you want to move, I want to move my image, my UFO. And how far I want to move this image on each axis, each coordinate. So what I want to do is update the x velocity, the x position of my image. So I'm going to pass in my x velocity variable. And then y will just keep the same for now, so we'll just say 0. So after each iteration of this while loop, my UFO is going to move one pixel to the right, and it's just going to go off into the void forever. And now if we replaced x velocity with 0, and for y we set this to our y velocity, this image is now going to travel down, and it will continue into the void forever. And then if we combine both of these together, we're going to move diagonally down and to the right. So what if we want this image to bounce off the walls? We're going to add some if statements. We're going to begin by just having this image bounce off the left and right walls. For now, let's set y velocity to 0 so that this image is only moving left and right. So before we move this image, we'll add an if statement. We're going to check to see if the x position of our image is either greater than the width of the canvas or if it's less than 0. So we take our coordinates and we're going to get the first element from this list. So that is 0. That is x, the x value. If coordinates at element 0 is greater than or equal to the width of this window, and this is a constant, so we can just place that here. If coordinates, well, x within our coordinates is greater than or equal to width, or coordinates at index 0 is less than 0, then we want to reverse the direction or flip the velocity. So we want to change our x velocity and make this a negative number. One easy way to do that is that we can take x velocity equals x velocity times negative 1. Or another way of writing this is just to say x velocity minus negative velocity. Now what ends up happening is that when this image reaches the right border, it's going to bounce back. However, it only bounces back after it reaches the top left corner of the image. We need to factor in the width of the image as well. So we're going to create two new variables, and let's do this right before the while loop. We'll want to determine what the height and the width are for our photo image that we have. So this is what we're going to write. Let's call these two values image underscore width and image underscore height. So we need to determine what the width and the height is for our photo image, and there is a function to do that. Type in the name of the photo image, dot, and there is a width function. And the same thing for height. Photo image dot height. And then we can reuse these. So I'm just going to add one line to this if statement. If the X position of our image is greater than or equal to the width of our window minus the width of our image. And I'm just going to put these within parentheses just to keep these more organized. And what ends up happening now is that when the right portion of our image hits the right wall, it's going to bounce off. And let's do the same thing for our Y velocity. We're going to replace coordinates at index 0 with 1 and change that here as well. Replace width with height. And this is image underscore height. And we're going to change the Y velocity this time. And when we move this image, let's also add the Y velocity. And now our image is just going to bounce off the walls forever, but it's kind of predictable since we set X and Y to equal 1. Now let's change the speeds to kind of spice things up. Let's say for the X velocity, this is 3, and Y velocity, this is now 2. This is going to go in a completely different direction. So you can mess with the speeds however you want. So guys, how about we add a background image to this? Well, because we can. I'm going to reuse this image of space from my Java video on this same topic. I need to create a photo image from this, and I'm going to copy what we did for our normal image that we were moving and animating. So this is called space.png. Well, that's the name of my file. And I'm going to give this image a different name. Maybe I'll call this background underscore photo. And then I'm going to add this photo to the canvas. And I'm going to call this a different name. I'll just call this background. All right, so our window should have a background now, and then our image moves on top of the background. So make sure you add and create the background before you add any other images. Otherwise, the background might overlap your image. All right, so that's the basics of some simple animations in Python. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of some animations in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.